It's a rule of capture in Texas. If you get the water, you get to use it. There's no regulation to try to divide it up and say, okay, well, this much for agriculture, this much for oil and gas. And that actually has presented a problem. Oil and gas is so much money that they can outbid everyone else. There is a movement right now, mostly being led by companies, to use brackish water, to figure out the chemistry so that right now mostly it's fresh water that's being used. And frankly, the reason fresh water is being used is that that's where they figured out the chemistry for it. It's not because fresh water necessarily is that much better. So they're trying to figure out, can we use these aquifers, brackish, salty aquifers that aren't good for drinking, aren't good for cattle, can we figure out how to use that to do fracking? And from what I understand, progress is slow, but it's encouraging. So hopefully there's going to be, you know, when we have this conversation again in 2 or 3 years, that potable water won't be used anymore. It'll be using water that we can't use.
Mark Sobeck, waterless fracking, other kinds of, can fracking become cleaner through technological innovation?
It can come, well, first is the, you know, move away from fresh water, as Russell was saying. There really are no impediments to that. If you think about an offshore drilling platform, we've all seen photos of them, they don't drill those wells with fresh water. They don't frack those wells with fresh water. The industry knows how to work with salt water, and they should. So in areas where water is scarce, there should simply be a movement to brackish and saline water. It's knowable technology. It's used all the time. There are alternatives to using water at all. Nitrogen has been used as a frack fluid. CO2 has been used as a frack fluid, and there are real advantages. And that's being seriously looked at right now. While we have too much CO2 in the atmosphere, it's actually hard to get. If you were actually a driller and you were fracking the well and you wanted to frack with CO2, it's harder to get and more expensive to pay for CO2 to do it. But there are actually advantages to using CO2. So we may well see more of that as, you know, supplies of CO2 can be made available, to the people in the field when they need it.